We read online that the taxi drivers will literally throw rocks at the Uber drivers. We literally had to get out of the Uber. I'm gonna cry because this is just ridiculous.
Please be nice. Please let us have a great time in your country. Don't be annoying.
Buenos dias. So we just made it to the bus station. It's not quite 6 a.m. in the morning. We are taking a bus to Colonia and then from Colonia a ferry to Argentina. However, the bus doesn't actually leave until 2 p.m. So why are we here so early? Because our host, they were on the way to Montevideo, so it worked out great. They were able to drop us off here at the bus station. And now we get some work done, which is good. We have been going too much and finally need to get some work done. Then probably sleep on the bus. And right now we're the only people at the bus station, us and the dog. It's $103 for both of us, and that's for a 7.5 hour journey. All right, so McDonald's is finally open, so we're gonna head to McDonald's. Grab some breakfast and hopefully get warm because it was kind of cold in that bus station. Apparently electric and heating is quite expensive in Uruguay, and so I don't think they wanted to have it on this morning. Oh, whoa, the fingers lit up. That looks creepy. Oh goodness, it might not be open. You're right. So why is it not open?
I looked online, I was reading reviews, and it said they had good Wi-Fi here. But I found one review that was talking about the Wi-Fi. It said they're only open from December through April because that's when all
summer.
The tourists are here.
Bummer. Punta del Este is definitely a summer vacation spot. This city floods from 15,000 to 250,000 people. So there are a lot of rental houses here, vacation houses, second homes, things like that. So in the winter time, a lot of things shut down. So, oh well, we will go to the port, visit the port. All right, we were getting some great work done here in the bus station. So we ended up coming back here. There was a cafe that opened up here, has really good Wi-Fi. We ended up having two meat pies, a cheese empanada, and now our bus leaves in 20 minutes, so quickly finishing our meal. The times that we're about to miss the bus is when we've been here for so many hours, we get wrapped up in work, and then we're like, oh no, we've gotta go. This is tuna. It's really yummy. That sounds warm. Oh guys, we got way too used to warm weather. I was Peter, no way is it over 40 degrees. And he's it's 58. I was are you kidding? It is raining, it's very cloudy. So that does affect, but I'm all bundled up. That was a fast turnaround. So we made it back to Montevideo and we had 15 minutes. We had to pay $5 for our passes to be printed off.
But all possible, print yours first.
I know, we just didn't have access to a printer. No. We grabbed McDonald's really fast, and now we're heading on the bus. It takes us to Colonia and then taking the ferry. Like I said, today we will eventually get to Buenos Aires. It's been a long time coming. We've definitely been impressed with Uruguay's buses. They are really nice. They have on schedule. They have bathrooms. McDonald's was good. And then we had some leftovers, peanuts and raisins from when we bought way too much in Hawaii. So we're about the end of that. And then we'll have to get some more snacks. Heading to the ferry. This is a nice one. All right, time to go back into Argentina and officially count it.
es ilegal. Vos venís a una parada.
No, 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 me voy.
Bájalo.
No, no, pero son los americanos.
No, bájalo. Bájalo porque yo te pido apoyo y va a ser peor.
Sí, no, 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 sí,
bueno,
bájalo. Bueno, bájense porque no quiere el servicio de taxi.
¿Por qué?
No quiere el servicio de taxi.
He doesn't want.
Pues la parada, tenían que haber sido más para allá. Si se van por la otra esquina caminando, los levanto.
We don't... walk up a ways?
Claro.
We were told the taxi drivers do not like Uber drivers, and we are finding that to be the case. We literally had to get out of the Uber and walk up a ways, and now the Uber drivers are going to pick us up because we were in the taxi region. Crazy taxi driver. Holy cow, we went to walk up a ways, and that crazy taxi driver literally followed this guy. I want to cancel this trip. Babe, I don't... Can you just cancel? I don't want road rage. We read online that the taxi drivers will literally throw rocks at the Uber drivers. Just say we don't want any... Just we'll just say no Quiero and just get another Uber driver. Just order another Uber driver. Let this crazy taxi guy leave. He literally is like stalking the Uber driver. This is ridiculous. It's 10 o'clock at night. We woke up at 5. I'm exhausted. I'm gonna cry because this is just ridiculous. We had an Uber driver here and
the Uber driver was super sweet,
he
super
was so nice,
nice. But the taxi drivers are really stinking.
They boxed him in. There were two taxi drivers that boxed him in, so he literally couldn't leave. We had to get out of the car. Like, and I'm just like, I don't want any violence here because he had read
stop,
that.
Stop. You need to stop. You're about to like cry. You need to stop.
I know.
So the bottom line is, yeah, they like really hate the Uber drivers apparently, but.
Well, we went in and asked the Coast Guard, can an Uber driver pick us up here? And they said, yeah, no problem.
Uber descargada acá en tu teléfono. Vos podés llamar un Uber desde acá para que te venga a buscar.
It's not very welcoming, and unfortunately, we don't know enough of the language to talk to the taxi driver and be like, hey, buddy, can you please be nice? We're from USA, you know, we're trying to visit, we're trying to have a good time here
driver,
in your country. Please be nice. Please let us have a great time in your country. Don't be annoying.
The Uber driver was like, they're Americans. Like, be nice. He said that.
He was trying, the Uber driver was great. He was trying to help us out.
He was calm, too.
Yeah.
All right. You gotta pay attention and get another driver and stay away from these stinking... Is that the same taxi driver? And 25 minutes later, we finally have another Uber on its way with a bunch of taxi drivers that just passed. I hope they don't stop. Like, I'm just so done. I just want to go to bed. I just want to go to bed. All right, some other Uber drivers, like, canceled and stuff. So hopefully we're good. Finally. Hola.
Hola.
For Uber drivers?
Yeah, we have to take care. What's your
name? I'm from Colorado Springs. In Colorado, it's right in the middle. We talked to the National Guard and they're like, yeah, it's fine.
Bienvenido.
Welcome to Argentina.
Country number 59. Whoa. Oh my goodness. What a journey to get to this Airbnb. We got here before 11 o'clock. It's been a long day. We are excited to explore Buenos Aires, I don't know how to say it yet, tomorrow. Just got done talking with the Airbnb host. Super helpful. Let us know all these different places and things to see and what to do. And make sure not to put your coat on the back of a chair or have your bag with you, because this city is known for pickpocketing and things like that. So
it's a reputation, so you just gotta be street smart.
Yep.
But yeah, she was so nice. She had been waiting for us downstairs outside in front of the apartment for like 40 minutes is what she said.
And she's, it was like, pretty cold outside too.
Which we would have been there like right on time had the taxi driver not scared off our Uber driver.
Exactly.
But yeah. Thankfully, she had a book. She was like, it's no problem. I had a book. I was reading.
So sweet.
But she's amazing.
Adios. We will see you tomorrow as we explore the city. And behind me here, this is a taste of the city. This is Tango. And this is the city that Tango started in. Yeah, so we're taking the CCAT Cologne. Well, never mind. I'm filming my phone, so it's not showing up very good. Bathroom.